Morning, boys and girls. Can you believe it's Friday, the end of another week, another exciting assembly? We're going to find a pyramid in a forest park, tell you the story of Egypt, baby Jesus having to escape. We're going to sing It's Christmas, the angels are singing. Then we're going to finish with Hallelujah. Don't forget, if you're watching and you can enter the competition, they're going to give out 5 school classrooms today across the country. If you're watching, I want the name of the school, the teacher, and their class. For example, Mrs. Jones, Timbuktu Primary School, P5, for example. And we'll show you where to send that to at the end. Sing along. Angels are singing. Ready? But we're going to go to Garba Forest Park to tell you the story of Egypt when baby Jesus had to escape for his life. Ready?
Boys and girls, we've come to the final day of the Christmas story this week, out and about. And I'm in Garba in the forest park, and I've come across a very, very interesting thing. And it starts with P, and you'll find it in Egypt. We're going to go to Egypt today in the Christmas story. And the thing we're going to talk about is a big pointy thing. Yes, does anyone know what it is? Kings or pharaohs would have built them in Egypt. And when you go to Egypt today, you'll see them out in the desert. Big, tall, pointy things. And they're called pyramids in Egypt. This is in Garba, and it's built over 200 years ago. The man who lived there was called Lord Garba, and he wanted to be buried here and use it as a tombstone. But if you go to Egypt, you'll see lots of these, and they're famous throughout Egypt as places where pharaohs or kings would have been buried, and they wanted pyramids built for all to see. But I thought about the Christmas story. So far this week, we've talked about, remember Mary and Joseph, the angel would come to Zechariah, and the angel would come to Joseph and warn Joseph that Mary, the woman he was engaged to, Mary, was expecting a baby. And Joseph was really troubled by this here, because he thought, we haven't been with each other. We're not married, therefore it's impossible for her to have a child. But the Bible says that the Holy Ghost came upon Mary, and she was now going to have a baby. But God, the Holy Ghost, came upon Mary, and God wanted a human being, as a virgin, somebody who was never married before, to bring the Christ child, the baby Jesus, into the world. And Mary had never been with man. She was not married, and she fitted the criteria, and God chose Mary. Blessed are you among, not above. Mary was no more special than anyone else. She was just like any other people. And sometimes in parts of the world, people lift Mary up almost above Jesus or above God. But boys and girls, remember, Mary was just the instrument used to bring baby Jesus into the world. A wonderful girl, but no more special than anyone else. God could have chosen anyone. But the focus, of course, was on baby Jesus. Remember the shepherds. When the shepherds heard the news, they had a choice. Do we just wait here? The Bible says no. Immediately they ran to find Jesus. And whenever they ran into the stable, do you know what they done? They did not worship Joseph, or they did not bow down to Mary, but it says they worshiped him, the Christ child. And whenever the wise men came, who did they give their gifts to? They give the gifts to the baby, not to the mother. They give the gifts to the baby, the lovely baby Jesus. And then, remember Pharaoh? Whenever the wise men came to visit baby Jesus, they got lost and they came to Jerusalem. And they said, we're looking for the king. And King Herod said, king? What king? I'm the king. Then he thought, is there another king? Go and find him. And when you find out where he is, come and tell me where he is, because I want to worship him as well. So what happened? They never come back, because an angel came in a dream and said to the wise men, go home a different way, because Herod is a wicked, evil man. And boys and girls, Herod was so angry, he was so cross. Do you know what he done? He told the soldiers to go to Bethlehem and find all the wee baby boys under 2 years of age, and I want you to kill them. Why? Because he wanted to kill baby Jesus. Why did he do that? Well, the devil, of course, remember, he did not want Jesus to come into this world. He did not want Jesus to go to the cross, because he knew once Jesus went to the cross and laid down his life and died and rose again, that means when people believe that, they can be brought back to God and be with God forever. And the devil does not want us to follow God, to worship God, to be with God. So he thought, if I can kill baby Jesus. But God sent Jesus into the world not to die as a baby. He sent him to go publicly to the cross to die for the sins of the world and to rise again from the dead. So they escaped. And what happened? An angel then came and warned Joseph in a dream, saying, Joseph, you need to get up and take the baby and escape to Egypt. And take Mary and take the baby, and off you go in your little donkey. And off they went, boys and girls, through the streets of Bethlehem, and they eventually crossed over the border, and that's where they came to Egypt, the land of the pyramids. Egypt was a different country, therefore they crossed over the border, and Herod could not touch them. And they stayed there for many years until Herod died. And a new king came who knew nothing about it. The baby was safe, and that's where they could come back and live in Nazareth. Joseph was a carpenter. And then baby Jesus grew up as a little boy, helping his father, learning his trade, learning just as a normal little boy in a carpenter's home. And that's when Jesus grew up. We knew until about 12 years of age about his childhood. Then we know nothing for the next 18 years. When he's age 30, the Gospels tell us he came back on the scene. He lived on this earth. He healed thousands of people, helped many people, preached the gospel. Many people followed him, but many didn't. And the most important part about Jesus' life was his death. Whenever they arrested him, they crucified him on the cross, and he shed his precious blood. The Bible says, without the shedding of Jesus' blood, we cannot be forgiven. But whenever I think, and then he died, he was buried, and 3 days later, praise God, he rose again. And he's ascended into heaven, and one day he's coming back again. That's why I love the Christmas story. It tells me in a nutshell the wonderful reason why God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Life forever with God whenever we believe in the Lord Jesus. So whenever you see the pyramids and think of Egypt, think of the time whenever Mary and Joseph had to escape with baby Jesus for his life because he was in danger of being taken by Herod and killed by the soldiers. But God was protecting his son for the purpose that his son was come into this world was to publicly die on the cross, to redeem people, to save the people, to bring us back. So boys and girls, another opportunity is given to you to hear the wonderful Christmas story. Don't miss it. The reason Jesus came into the world, the Bible tells me in Timothy, Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. So remember, he came into the world to save, not to live, but to save us by dying on the cross. He came to save sinners, and that's everyone right across the world, because the Bible says, as by one man, the first man, sin entered the world and death by sin. So Jesus came to take that away, to bring us back to God, to save us, to redeem us, so we can be reconciled, brought back to God, to be with God forever. A wonderful message. And right across the world, people are thinking more than ever about Christmas and the reason for Christmas. Christmas, the first letters in the word Christmas is Christ, and it should always be at the start of Christmas whenever we think about it. So this Christmas, think about the reason it came. And it came, we think about presents, we think about gifts, receiving gifts. And the Bible says about a gift, the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. We always like to receive a gift. Nobody refuses a gift. And God says, this is my gift to the world. This is my gift to you. It's my son, Jesus. And most of the world say, no, thank you. But boys and girls, I said, thank you very much. I wonder today, would you say thank you for the gift? Thank you for Jesus. Will you take him? Allow him into your life and into your heart to take away your sin so that he can live with you forever and you can be with God forever. What a Christmas this would be when you start living the Christian life by believing on the gift, receiving the gift, accepting the gift. It's a wonderful thing to be a Christian. Think about the pyramid, think about Egypt, think about the gift, Jesus, and why he came into the world and why Christmas is so special.
Really enjoyed that story. Even in a forest park, you can tell the story of Jesus. We're going to sing Hallelujah, but everyone who sings really well, there's a special bonus. If you sing this song really well, you can have the next 2 days off school, okay? If you can sing Hallelujah, you can have the next 2 days off school, okay? Thumbs up if you're happy. Good. Everybody's happy. Here we go. Hallelujah.
Like this, my fourth and fifth.
school, if you were singing, 2 days off school, if you can spell hallelujah, the next 2 days off school, tomorrow and the day after. Now, that's it for Friday. If you've been watching, don't forget, if you're watching, five schools, five classes are going to get a prize, a book, one of our new books, wonderful books. But the teacher must send in it by email, messenger, or WhatsApp, or text message, the name of the school, teacher, and the classroom. So many have entered already this week, and if you've entered, keep entering each day, and there's prizes going out on Monday. We're going to announce all the schools. That's it for this week. Don't forget, tonight, Friday night, we'll have a special Bible club every Friday night, 7 o'clock. Sunday school, more Bible teaching for children at 10:30. And every weekday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, assembly from 9 o'clock. That's me. By the way, the next 2 days are Saturday and Sunday.